Liverpool, tuning up for a bumper season, greets the Labour Party, enjoying a last council of war before the general election. Chief policymaker Herbert Morrison, setting the stage for the electoral battle, speaks about the nationalised industries with the Premier among his listeners.
I freely agree with my colleagues in the party that there remains plenty of room for improvement. We have only just taken them over. They have to be shaped to the new order of things. They have to be developed. And in my judgment, there will be room for criticism of socialized industries for quite a number of years to come. It'll be a marvel if they are not always open to criticism of some sort and another.
Making up with production his call to the nation, Mr. Morrison goes on to say,
unless the economic foundations are healthy, unless production is virile and adequate in amount, then all the rest of the program is bound to be in a state of risk of some sort. And I want nobody to have the illusion, either in the conference or outside, I want nobody to have the illusion that we can get things without earning them.
On the following day, an ovation greets that old conference favourite Ernest Bevin, paying a flying visit to Blackpool from his deliberations in Paris. The Foreign Secretary gains overwhelming support from the delegates as he gives them a review of the international situation.
There are some people in the world who think social democracy is weak and can't resist. Well, I believe you can build a stronger resistance on the hearts and courage of voluntary association through a democratic body which will stand longer in the long run than any dictatorship that has ever been invented. There's never been a dictator in the history of this world that hasn't talked peace when he's been preparing for war. Do bear that in mind. It's the largest army, the greatest power in the world that is mobilized today. And I want to see that brought to an end, not by war, but by example, remaining firm ourselves. I don't know what will happen. I'm not going to discuss Paris here this morning because you never know what may emerge before we break up. The only thing we can really do is, if we can't agree how we shall live, at least agree to live together.